And today, our main focus will be starting to understand and get to know open badges as a tool, as a solution for your programs. And this will be the main focus today. And before we enter the topic of today, I would like just to recap a little bit what's going on the Canvas platform. Already Limonas and Sandra invited you to log in to the Canvas platform, because at some point we will ask you to post directly to a specific discussion forum to make it lively. Just to let you know, we are here meeting in webinars, and I mentioned 40 people, close to 40 people. We invited around 70 to join webinars, and in total, more than 160 people were invited to join the course. So at the moment, I see that on Canvas platform, we have around 100 people who clicked registration link and joined the Canvas platform. So it means that when we think about learners group, we always think about you joining webinars, people maybe missing some webinars, so we keep following them on email and inviting to join the next webinar, plus an extended group of people who we invited to join a Canvas platform. And it might be that you will find some people posting whom you didn't meet on webinars, so don't be afraid. They are part of the group, just they learn on their own pace. Something what we picked up from discussions, especially the one which was in first module, the discussion about which invites you to share programs focused on digital literacy and 21st century skills. Many of you posted saying that you started using digital tools for learning, for connection with young people to implement your programs, which previously were done in a more person mode. But you were saying that you are not yet at the level of digital literacy program. That's all right, because the idea of this course is to introduce also to the concept of digital literacy itself and programs. So if you yet didn't start, a very conscious choice to include digital literacy programs in your work, maybe that's your chance to rethink the way your organization functions and what kind of programs you offer. And I will go still to explain a bit how we understand digital literacy and 21st century skills, which is another way to approach skills development. Ourselves, we follow both or combination, because we cannot imagine 21st century skills without some digital literacy level. So often it's part of 21st century skills. So in the forum where you post, or you were invited to post about your programs, you can also post about which programs you consider helping young people to develop 21st century skills. So that's also possible. And whenever you post, and some people did post information about programs where you allow young people to develop digital skills, please add also links where possible. If your organization has a description on website of that your program, or maybe you have a publication which describes the way the program functions, you can add this to discussion forum, because that helps other participants to better understand what kind of programs you work with. Again, I will encourage you to come back to discussion maybe after this webinar. And if you yet didn't post, share programs, which is about digital literacy, which means helping young people to develop digital skills, knowledge, attitudes necessary to be in better tune with technology, or 21st century skills, which is a wide framework. So posted, or a great post, even with promotional posters. And again, if you could also add links, already mentioned, for example, Tracer, you share a lot of good examples of projects your organization is involved. I only know the one which is Skillet project. So if you could come back and just post more links for people to be able to explore, that would be grateful.
No problem.
Thanks. From the webinar recording of the first meeting, we posted it for beginning. If you joined only the second one today, you will find the webinar recording available already on the introductory session overview of the course. So if you want to see what we were doing in the webinar, you can follow. Also, we will be recording today's webinar, so be aware of that. If you are not comfortable with video, so just switch off and that's all right. This is, again, for making sure that people who cannot attend webinars, follow the course on their own pace, they can have this feeling of what we do on webinars. And one other thing, what I want to touch a little bit entering the topic today, where is a session called What is Digital Literacy, where you would see a video from Doug Belashow, who is also a very big enthusiast of open badges. So consciously selected his video. He did his PhD on defining digital literacies. And where is even an extended book from his PhD available if you would like to go deeper. And he covers quite to a big extent what digital literacies are required today in this current society, life, and stage of development of technology. Additionally, we provide a few frameworks which we follow ourselves. I quickly checked how many 21st century skills and digital literacy models available, and I could find in reference of Wikipedia more than 13 collected. Of course, where will be each organization might develop their own framework, or perhaps in your country, where is a national framework for digital literacy or skills framework. So you may want also to check what's existing in your country. So far, we follow a bit of a European framework on digital competence, which is about essential skills, attitudes, and knowledge which citizens should have to be able to function successfully in society, which is highly digitalized. We use a lot of technologies and so on. And this framework was updated recently, including already levels of competence frameworks. This we also explored as part of our project, where some of the partners experimented with connecting our programs to the skill framework DIGCOM. You can also think how your programs, which you deliver with young people, can be connected to wider frameworks. And that will be also our topic when we start looking at badges. Another framework which we follow, it's from Mozilla. And Doug Belashow, again, was contributing a lot, but this one was developed with a community of people working on digital literacies across the world. And it is also linked to 21st century skills. So we looked at how which skills do we need to be functional, successful, good in 21st century today. And they also thought if we spend enormous amount of time socializing, learning, working, using technologies, so how these two connect. So how we can connect necessary skills to be able to function well with technology and 21st century skills. So that was one of the approaches Mozilla took. And what is interesting about this module, and if you will go to the website, that they made even a better step. So they had this interactive model. So you can click and select which is important skills. And then they created also resources for teaching digital literacies. So that's something interesting. So if you would be looking for how to deliver a workshop about people to learn how to design something, you can find resources available for a workshop. So that's something what may be interesting for the ones who yet in the level of looking for developing skills. And one skill framework which we found by searching on the internet was Global Youth Skills from the Institute for the Future. And this institute was researching which skills are necessary for the next decade. So this decade, actually, which we started this year, and how young people can develop these skills. So it's a kind of projection to the future. They took 9 scenarios of the future for 2030 and looked at which kind of skills people need to possess to be able to function well in the future. And then in our work, we follow this approach already now, seeing how our programs can help young people to develop necessary skills for the future, either for career, for personal development, or civic engagement. So these would be the starting points for understanding digital literacy and 21st century skills. And we will continue with open badges today. And you will be able to reflect, discuss, and start thinking where you can introduce badges in your programs to give additional value to what people learn in your programs. I see Domante is asking if the pace on Canvas activities related closely to webinars or more on the individual pace of participant. I could say it's both. In a way, we will follow the content path which we created on Canvas, complementing the webinar activities. Today, for example, we focus on essentials of open badges, and that's exactly the second module of open badges. Yet, we opened all four modules around open badges already now. So I saw already some people posted a few things on discussion forums from the second and third module. So that's already available. And we combine a bit webinars and modules. Time we follow all the webinars, and you will need to take your own pace with the course. Plus, there are more people who are not joining webinars, so they will be following the course on their own pace. Musti is asking about if four modules are unlocked, are we supposed to finish all? Or are we going to follow the sessions? And also referring to the three badges without any specific knowledge. So it is the way modules are working. They are unlocked and available. And if you go through the modules, the criteria for earning a badge is actually to view the content. What you do with the content, it will be your responsibility. So at the moment, the platform can only make criteria work if you view the content, but it doesn't require you to have a test or anything. Again, it's partly because we trust that people who go through the learning opportunities, they take responsibility for using them. We will not go for a test to know if you got knowledge or not. So be responsible in that sense. Anne is asking about assessment on the course on Canvas. There are possibility to use different skills. You think it makes sense to recognize in your programs can be really diverse ones. So you can think of any skill. And I think assessment will be also depending on what type of skill you want to recognize. While on Line platforms already have integrated assessment to some extent, but in workshops where, for example, people meet in groups, it might be that you can implement peer assessment, you can think of self-assessment or mentor assessment, so it can be different ones. Someone is asking how people can connect Canvas and Badgecraft. At the moment, we managed to build integration to offer badges, and we will be adding possibility to get them on your Badgecraft account. It's still in progress. For ourselves, we are also developing some of the technology behind badges, so it takes a bit of time. Yeah, and Limon is just making aware that you can use Canvas on your phone. You will find that some of the things are a little bit limited in terms of what content is displayed on Canvas, but most of it will be available on the app. So if you would search for Canvas Instructor app, you will find it available on Google Play and App Store for two main ones. Yeah, Domant is asking, can we share information and links from Canva to organization team? Yes, please do so. Even you can share the link to enroll to the course. So if you want with your organization's team to follow the course, invite them to join or use any material available. Everything what we create, it's available for sharing, reusing, remixing, and so on. So it's really open for reuse and sharing. Please do. All right. And something maybe to continue, whenever you have any question regarding the course, you can always write us a direct message on the course. On the very left side inbox, that's where actually you can post direct messages to us as facilitators. So if you start a new message and choose the course, I have a bit few of them. So let's say Limonas. I want to send a message to Limonas or Sandra or three of us. And then you can directly send any message to, through this channel, or we are still keeping an email communication throughout this week. Then we can get it via email as well. Okay. So to continue, today we will focus on open badges, and you will be able to, I'm referring also to what's available on Canvas because that will stay and you can find it. So we recorded a video about Open Badges Essentials, which explains actually the technology and what is actually Open Badges in details. That's one thing what we will definitely cover today. Also, we will go into specific features of Open Badges as digital credential. You will hear this word digital credential. Very often it's used in the context of validation of learning outcomes, recognition, assessment. So in this context, you would hear about credentials, something which shows what I have learned, what kind of knowledge, experience, skills I possess. And so open badges have something to offer, which is specific, digital, the credential, flexible, granular, evidence-based, verified, shareable, and transferable. That would be the keywords, if going quickly. And one other thing what we added to the course is, which we found out very often when people start talking and thinking about badges, is how to create a good badge. So we also created a video especially for this course, which says and tells more specifically how to create a good badge. But here on webinars, we will want you to mostly practice and talk and think together with other participants on, first of all, what badge can show in terms of skills for you, for your programs, for your organization, which programs you want to use as basis to develop badges, and where exactly on a specific program you want to introduce badges. So that's what we want to offer today. Sandra?
Yes. Good morning to everybody that I haven't seen. Wait a minute. Most people have more experience than have been recognized for. And what we want to ask you to chat about in breakout rooms is which experiences and skills do you have that are not yet recognized? So you will be in a group with five other people, and this group will be the same also in during this whole Zoom meeting. So you will be back in another Zoom together after this. So you will have 20 minutes and chat about what experience and skills do I have that I do not have recognized for. We will now look at situations and places where badges can be used for and what. So you have talked about in the breakout room about what experiences and skills do you have that yet are not recognized before. And now we are going to open badges where to be used. When I want to say in simple words, what is a digital badge, then I could say it's an indicator of an accomplishment or a skill or quality or an indicator of interest. So an open badge can be displayed and accessed and verified online. And they can be earned in a variety of environments and a variety of learning opportunities. So we see them in higher education. We see them in lifelong learning programs. We can even see them here in the Canvas online training and in residential training courses, boot camps, and via awarding bodies. We can also see them in businesses like IBM, Adobe, Cisco, Samsung, and even in some military, some badges are showing up. Also, we have situations where municipalities who want to support citizens, for example, with well-being and their career path. Sometimes open badges are issued for achievements involving a great effort, such as completing an exam for a total formal education path or passing a course with formal accreditation. And other times they are giving out for some low stakes tasks, such as watching a video, taking a conference, taking part in a specific part of a conference, or going through an online or residential youth exchange program. What are potentials of open badges? Badges have been used successfully to set goals, motivate behavior, represent achievements, and communicate successes. At the moment, what we see is that traditional formal education is challenged because of the rapid changes resulting from the globalization or demographic trends and the migration. Also, information and communication technologies create opportunities to help transform the traditional educational places and practices. For example, it is nowadays easier to follow a specific course that interests you online at the moment that fits you best. We see in our youth work practices that open badges are supporting the achievements of youth work organizations because the open badges make visible what a young person have learned or achieved or experiences and many other things during a youth work activity. What we also see is that open badges can enhance inclusion and can improve access to quality education at all levels. For example, here in the Netherlands, there are some formal education institutes that support people who are not learning best in a formal education program, but now they are learning at the workplace. And so young people are not even going to a classroom anymore, but this is supported by open badges. So the process is followed by open badges. Creating smaller steps during these learning processes and supported by recognition of the learning during these small steps, young people are getting more aware of their achievements and that way they are more motivated, can be more motivated to go on with learning. We also see that open badges can support a lifelong learner. As I look to myself earning badges during activities for the last 4 years, I now have these learning achievements in my badge wallet. And my badge wallet, full with badges, is an app that makes my achievements visible and stored. I also have them at the same time at my phone or at my laptop. So, open badges, why should we use them? Yeah, open badges are one of the promising approaches to online credential, which can exist alongside and complementary to the more traditional credentials as diplomas and certificates. By using open badges, the educators or youth workers or employers are able to create ways to recognize more diverse learning pathways and more opportunities for lifelong learners. It can support competency-based and competency-focused credentialing in the context of open education. Open badges can also ensure legitimization of skills and competences that traditionally are not recognized in a formal education degree, but are of much value in the modern society nowadays. So, for example, we can name the 21st century skills. Open badges can also facilitate social inclusion for disadvantaged groups such as migrants or refugees or people who don't fit in a formal education situation. And it can support solving unequal access to education. When I think about why should we use open badges, I also think about that the earner can have the control. Open badges have become an unofficial global standard, yet the specifications remain free. Although in some countries, open badges are already by law equal to certificates and diplomas, an open badge even can provide learners with a sustainable record of achievements, which they can control. It offers an opportunity to not only represent skills and achievements, but as well, it can represent trust, relationships, and reputation. Limenus, I think we are then going to you, is it?
Yes, so we can see how many possible purposes and areas of use is there. Thanks, Sandra, actually, for giving that very wide picture. And someone can say, wow, seems like badges are almost everywhere. And indeed, open digital badges were introduced by Mozilla Foundation in 2010-11. And since then, as it was given to community of practice, to anyone to try out badges in their own context, I think that's where diversity came, that nobody was telling what badges are for and what they are not. And so there was really all these years of organizations experimenting with badges and trying things out. And it was really nice to see in the chat, I asked people to share a bit from the groups what skills were mentioned, skills that you have, but not recognized really. There is no official certificate or diploma, and we have a huge list of things from being a mom or riding a bicycle or being passionate in photography or whatnot, really, or teaching or many other things that we gain through our activities in organizations and volunteering or just throughout the life. And with badges, actually the community, so people, organizations, they can make their choice. They can make their own decision what they would like to use badges for and create their unique recognition system. And that's one of the valuable things, I think, that are not centrally controlled, but actually it gives freedom to decide what open badges can recognize in your context, what makes sense. We will soon get back to here, to the activities, and we'll do a little bit of analysis of your own context. What programs are you running right now or you were doing recently? What's going on there and where perhaps badges can have a role in these programs? And now we make a short break. So yeah, we actually can come back at in 10 minutes, 9 minutes just now. So at 11, I think on Sandra's clock, at 12, my clock. So 9 minutes to have some water, tea, coffee, and start now already thinking a bit, what are the programs you are implementing with young people and how do they look like? And I will invite you for a bit of journey to remember these programs. You may want to close your eyes, perhaps. And I'd like to invite you to think now about landscape of what you are doing in your organizations, in your work. So yeah, relax, close your eyes, and try to roll like a movie in front of you, like some highlights from recent programs that you're implementing with young people. What do you see? Who are those people? What's the feeling there in the room or in some open space? What people are doing? And try also to remember a moment when people talk to you, perhaps. What did they learn in that program? What did they experience? What were the highlights? Also, maybe you had a moment when people share what was challenging, what was difficult in that program, in that activity. So try to remember and feel the recent program that you were doing. And now I'd like to try that, if you were like zooming in at certain moments, now try to zoom out and see a bit from far away. It's like a movie rolling, but a bit from further. And try to spot some red lights or things that call for your attention. And especially things where you felt maybe there was lack of engagement from people. Maybe there was lack of motivation. Or maybe you felt people got lost in the learning process. Or there was no clarity what's going on right now. Or maybe people were not very sure about how assessment is happening, for example, how people can know if they learned something. Or maybe there were moments when, like in the discussion you had before, maybe there are moments when you think people really learned something important, but they missed that. You know, maybe some moments when you feel like, oh, actually that was an important moment, but it's somehow lost, or really people were not aware of that thing they got. Yeah, so try to memorize these few spots, few moments from your recent program, and then further zoom out, and then come back here to this meeting. Come back to this meeting, you can open your eyes. So we wanted to give you some space for you actually to remember some programs and remember some moments where you felt maybe there were some challenging aspects there. And perhaps there is a space where open badges can come in. And open badges is not the cure for everything, for sure. And that's what we're also describing and saying in the online course. But open badges are good when we talk about increasing engagement, increasing visibility of skills learned, recognition of skills acquired, can be also motivation as well. So we will now invite you to breakout rooms, and there we ask you to share a bit which program you think you would use badges for. Yeah, what kind of activity that you think actually you saw maybe in that journey a lack of engagement or lack of motivation or lack of recognition, so that you could tell to other colleagues which activity or program you're thinking about where you potentially could use badges. Or some of you, I know for sure some of you using badges already, maybe you think of adding some extra layer of badges or improving how badges functioned in the past and you want to add new element. So both options are okay. So we'll invite you there now to share which program potentially you could think of where badges could be useful. And please do share it with your peers. And I see Nerius posted this already. And then when you will share and maybe you make your mind, not necessarily the very beginning, maybe during the conversation, when you will share your thoughts and make decision which program you're going to use badges for, we invite you to go to our online course, to the platform, and post in the discussion 2.6, which program are you choosing? And you see already some posts there. If you cannot connect for some reason, that's okay. Then just make note for yourself somewhere and you can write it later after the webinar. Okay, so we are allocating for this approximately 25 minutes. So in these 25 minutes, make sure you share briefly about the programs and most important, what could be possible objectives or goals? Why would you like to use badges there? And make a short post on the discussion forum. Okay, so these are the tasks. Welcome back, everyone. We would be really curious to hear at least few people to share how was it for you to find that program and especially to identify what would you use badges for. So if you, some of you could share, we would love to hear. And you can click on reactions, raise hand, and so we know who wants to speak. Also, if my colleagues spot someone raising a physical hand, inviting you to share. Audrey, please.
I want to, we all had a nice discussion about how to implicate the badges everywhere. So it was not mainly about what we will do because we all had some ideas of using it. But in the end, we were thinking about how we can implicate it in on by different companies and educations, because we, in the end, we all are, I don't know the words, but system, it's a part of the whole charade. So we were arguing how can we make this work? So how can we introduce it? And yeah, I don't know if you understand me, I try to summarize it, but it was a lot that we were saying. I don't know if someone of my team wants to elaborate or.
Yeah, just a quick reaction. I think the question you are asking, it comes very often from people when, you know, they get excited about the idea. And then the question is how to start? What's the first step, right? And we're inviting you really to go through the course. And then we shared also some steps. For example, a session, module 4 starts with the first session where we share also from our practice, like what are the first steps to consider when starting with badges? What are the first decisions? And actually, if you manage to identify goals for badges or identify the program and objectives for badges, that's a good first step. Then the next step probably would be around just talking to colleagues from the same organization or trainers, facilitators, or youth workers who are running program together with you to make that decision and identify where badges can help in addressing some challenges in the program, and then start trying out badges, creating them, consulting with young people, how do they look like, and so on. Very often young people can also feedback quite well to how badges look. Also what badges recognize, because they are the ones to tell where, what kind of badge they would appreciate getting. And yes, I have. Thanks, Lena, for sharing. Claudia, please.
And besides the three people who raised hands, also Sala is raising physical hands. So just to make sure that we don't miss.
Yeah, because I was in the group with Leanne just to try to maybe to explain what we were discussing more. We will also discussing in the first part how we're going to implement in our organization the open badge system. That is not so hard part. The most challenging thing for us is what to do after with those badges for our young people who, because for example, in our organization, we are working with the people from fewer opportunities, and we are strengthening them to be more employable. But what about when the young people are coming to some institutions or organizations which are not recognizing open badges as a valuable system for acknowledgement of certain skills? So we were thinking also in the wider perspective what to do with the open badges, maybe to promote them in our networks of youth workers or networks for businesses or something like that. That's just what came to our mind regarding the discussion.
Yeah, I think, Sala, you're touching upon the important topic of creating the ecosystem of recognition. People learn something somewhere, right? If open badges recognize that learning, then who can make use of that information, of that data? How people can be visible and discoverable, or their skills, how can they be discovered, and how it can help in the next step when people finish certain program and activity. So I think that connection with the external partners, stakeholders, potential employers, employment offices is especially important when thinking of a system. But very often at the beginning, it's too much to think of all the organizations and so on. So that's why we often say, try out small steps first, try to see what's the reaction from people, and then start looking for the other partners who might be endorsing badges and maybe unlocking new opportunities for people who already have maybe a collection of badges, and most important, they have a collection of skills and competences, which is usually interesting for others who are looking for talents and for people to employ.
Yeah, for example, in Serbia, if you come to the, I don't know, to some company, if they see in your biography the badges, they will ask, oh, what are those cute icons in your CV?
Yeah, sure.
And that's exactly what you need to do. Because what we heard from companies, many young people lack any idea of what they can tell about their good practices and good experiences. So if a company will spot on their CVs some icons as badges, that's already good job you did, because these young people will have a chance to speak about their experiences. So your task is to prepare young people, then they will be asked about what is this lovely icon, that they should focus and talk exclusively about experiences which brought them skills and what they can do with these skills. You perfectly picked it up. What could be the function of badges in helping young people to talk about their experiences? Yeah.
Thank you, Nerius. Ore?
Okay, thank you. So in our group, we had a mix of people who had used badges before and people who hadn't. And so I think we all shared. So I shared my experience with my organization and us using the badges in some of our programs as we moved our programs online last year. And Henry also shared, Henry from Ready for Work also shared, Ready for Life also shared some of his experiences too. So among our group members who had never used badges, they had questions on how they could apply it to their particular sets of beneficiaries. Some were young children from like about five or six, and some worked with like adults, so adult learning. So we discussed that a bit. And so my suggestion was just give it a go, try it, even within a small, maybe a small program or small subsect of your beneficiaries, and you learn along the way. I think we also tried to really plan and try and figure everything out before we started, including what can we use these badges for? Why would, you know, organizations be interested in implementing the open badges? And but we decided to use our organization as a case study, test it out, and then probably go back to some of our beneficiaries last year and find out how they were using the badges. We basically shared with them that, oh, you can put it on your LinkedIn, you can share it, you can put it on your CV. And so for us, it'll be interesting to go back and find out maybe how they used it, what kind of conversations it stirred up. Yeah.
Thank you, Aria, for sharing. And I know Aria had a journey of open badges last year, trying out, experimenting open badges in your programs with young people, right? In the makerspace and so on.
Yeah, and what I like to add also is that there is also a wide network already using open badges, which and a lot of people are happy to share and learn from each other. So reaching out to a bigger network outside your own organization and share your experience is also important to do.
I saw Joanna, but are you still willing to share a bit?
Thank you. We had the room number 3 and the conversation was really cool with the guys because you were like asking some questions like why even we have recognized like to connect it to the before question, like why even we have recognized we have some skills, but they are not recognized. Why don't we get them recognized? So like the open badges are the good way to use them and to show. And also like sometimes we need some motivations and even the small things like the open badges, like even you get something because you did something, like to show you that you can do more things and it's recognized. And some people like need some kind of motivation to use that. So it's really great. But also we were discussing like sometimes, as you mentioned before, Sale, that it's hard to know how it works and so on. And sometimes even on the Erasmus projects, for example, it can be used, but we have to explain how it works and so on to that they will understand how to then have them recognized. So thanks.
Thank you for sharing. And I think that's an important question to ask ourselves. If we have skills that are not recognized, why they are not recognized, but also what we're going to do with that recognition or with that visibility, how it can be useful. Yeah. And you mentioned also, for example, universities, where we see more and more universities trying to really recognize everything else that happens beyond the walls of lectures. There's so much going on, so many activities in the campus. And we see increasing interest, really, that young people would leave universities or colleges, not just with diploma, but also with additional portfolio of skills, whatever they did and practiced throughout these years. So it's not just about grades, but it's much more about the personality and qualities that people bring from these experiences. All right. Thanks a lot for sharing that. Okay. So we are almost at the end of our second session. And Nerio's gonna take us through some things that you can find in the online course and also a couple of tasks we expect you to complete by Friday.
So let me share the screen. What would be really good for you to do until the Friday webinar is go through the essentials of open badges and examples of open badge systems, which we collected for module 2 and 3. And especially in order to be able to do practical tasks, it would be great for you to watch videos to better understand essence of badges. So there is one about what is an open badge, and we explain what it consists of, how this digital standard became available, what does it include, and so on. Then how to create a good badge, some criteria for good description, because badge will have a description of certain achievements, skills. You can also have a look into types of badges, because we already mentioned that badges can be used for different purposes and reasons. And for reasons, even you can go to another session, which is all about finding a good combination of what kind of things can be represented by a badge and why. And if you yet didn't have chance to post in this discussion forum, why would you use open badges in your programs? It's a good opportunity. If you look for ideas, where are already people posting them? So you could have a look into posts of others. And one thing what I want to show now is which tool you can use to create your first badges. On our course, we will introduce to several of them. Some people already started to use Cities of Learning platform, which we will come back to later stage. At this stage, we want you to go and use the platform called Badgecraft, which is our initial platform where we started to do badge activities. And on this badge platform, Badgecraft platform, when you log in, you will have a possibility to go to either Badge Wallet or Badgecraft. Badge Wallet is where you collect your badges as a learner and you organize them in collections. You see which badges you got, which quests you are in progress, and so on. For this Badge Wallet, we also have a mobile application, which allows you to easier manage badges as a learner, plus help with evidence. But if you want to create a badge, you need to go to Badgecraft. And for the ones who have organization created here, you will already have it in the list. If not, you create one. Just describe a bit name and all this information. I will give example from Nectarus. Then you have your organization's profile. You can create an activity for which you will be creating badges. Again, I will go quickly. Let's say there is a training program which we implemented some time ago, DigiLand. And in that program, people were learning different skills and competences, how to create digital programs for young people. So what we did, we created a badge system, and you don't need to go yet for the badge system. More think about which badges for which activities, for which skills you would like to offer. So your task is for next webinar to have at least 3-4 badges related to the programs which you offer to young people and create these badges for your program. So let's say here an example is something local activity. People need to do local investigation, and that describes what this badge represents and which tasks they need to do. So then you will start creating badges. You will need to click modify, and then you will be able to add badges to your system. Create a badge, and here basic information about how to create and what you need to describe. Some will be required, as you can see, and some will be optional. For badge images, we suggest to use Canva platform or other. On the course, we collected some examples how you can create a badge. You will be able to decide how the badge should be issued. Will it require evidence, or it will be issued for accomplishment from organizers? If you will choose issued with evidence, you will need to describe task and who is assessing evidence, how many people are assessing evidence, and so on. So play with it, experiment. You will discover a few new things for sure. So your task will be, first of all, to go through the content available in module 2 and 3, and then create at least 3-4 badges on Badgecraft platform. So that will be your task for next webinar. And don't be afraid to get into troubles creating badges. It's part of the learning. It's not like we do everything from beginning easy and so on, but make your notes what seems to be challenging, maybe unclear, when you want to create a badge. And to get you into the mood of creating your first badge or maybe continuing creating badges, I want to post one question in the chat and think of it and respond. What do you need to start or continue creating badges for your programs? So what are the things you need in order to start creating, or if you're already creating, maybe continue creating badges for your programs. Tracy is already putting time, budget time. When we were working with several organizations, we always recommended if you go on a badge journey, make it as integral part of your work and programs you do, which means allocating staff time for badge design, testing, and piloting. That's necessary. So I think how you can get time, it's if strategically you say recognition is part of our objectives. And if it's part of your organization's objectives, it means you need to allocate budgets. Either you talk to funders or you apply for funding to make sure that your staff, volunteers, have resources to work with badges. Yeah, Mariana is saying that need participants to understand the badges, potential value. It will come eventually when you will start presenting badge system or idea of badges to your participants. They will ask a lot of pragmatic questions. Time, again, coming from Salah through this, that you need time to really adopt open badge system. Again, coming back to the same what I talked when responding to Traces. Knowledge to create open badges, good. That's what we created for you on Canvas. Objectives of your program. Indeed, when we were working and keep working with several organizations, very often organizations need to rethink their objectives of their programs in order to be sure what they deliver, because that's requirement to define badge system. Researching needs of your target groups, yes. Lenny is also repeating needs of participants. You could also have focus groups with your participants to understand what they learn, what they value in that learning or outcomes or skills, and where and how they would imagine presenting these skills. So maybe at least three questions you can ask to ex-participants of your programs to understand better where to put focus on. When we were designing some of the programs, we actually organized focus groups with participants from previous editions of programs to understand better. Yeah, understanding awareness of open badges. It's good to involve participants and other people in badge system design. I see Renee's posting, discuss with the team and volunteers. Actually, by just starting discussions in your organizations, you already make people more aware of this opportunity. So I think it's important. And also you early collect feedback and ideas. Christian is posting that it's good and important to find the right award system approach, good balance between accomplishments and badge accomplishments, not to ask something which is maybe too extra or not enough big or important for people. Rasa is posting to present the goals and benefits of using open badges. Yeah. And discuss with colleagues. Again, involve your colleagues in discussion. So even when you have the first badges created, maybe it's worth checking with your colleagues, volunteers, and participants. What do they think about them? And that's why we want you to practically create badges, because it is much easier to speak with others. If you just make a discussion on a very abstract level, people might be lost. But if you show a couple of badges ready, almost, you say, what do you think if we would start using these badges? And you show description, you show how they look like and how people can get them, maybe that would be more practical. All right. Thank you for those who posted in the chat. Let's keep exploring resources available on Canvas. And your practical task will be on a Badgecraft platform to create 3 to 4 badges for the next webinar on Friday. Meet you again, same time for the webinar start. And looking forward for that.